Viruses have always been peculiar than other forms of life. They do not have a proper cell. They are simple entities consisting of one or more molecules of DNA or RNA enclosed in a protein coat. Rarely, carbohydrates and lipids might also be present. Viruses are also obligate parasites. They cannot multiply outside a living host cell as they do not have the complete machinery to multiply. They depend on their host cell's machinery to replicate. So basically, viruses exist in two phases, the extracellular and the intracellular phase. As extracellular virion particles, they cannot replicate. But when intracellular, the viruses exist primarily as replicating DNA or RNA. They induce host cells to synthesize virion components like DNA, RNA, or coat proteins. Eventually, virion particles are assembled and hundreds of these particles are released from the host cell. Also, viruses are tiny. Most viruses are found to be smaller than bacteria. Typical size of viruses is believed to be 20 to 400 nanometer. But recently, much larger viruses have been discovered. Mini viruses have been found with more than 1,000 genes and particle size of more than 700 nanometer. More recently, giant DNA viruses named Pandoraviruses have been discovered. One of these viruses was isolated from Chile coast and one from a freshwater source in Australia. These viruses are huge. They have been found to have particle size of 1 micrometer length and 0.5 micrometer diameter. The genome size is found to be about 2.5 megabase pairs. These viruses were found to infect some amoeba species. These particles lack the machinery necessary for protein production, energy generation, and cell division, thus confirming their viral nature. Pandoraviruses were grown on cells of amoeba Acanthamoeba castellani to study the replication cycle of these viruses. The replication cycle is 10 to 15 hours long. The virus particle is first internalized by the amoeba cell in an organelle called vacuole. The envelope of the virus then fuses with the vacuole membrane, creating a channel. The contents of the virus particle are emptied in the amoeba cell through this channel. This is followed by an eclipse phase where the contents of the virus become invisible. 2 to 4 hours later, the host nucleus loses its spherical appearance. The nuclear envelope develops multiple invaginations. 8 to 10 hours after infection, new virus particles start appearing in place of the host nucleus. These particles are synthesized and assembled simultaneously. Eventually, the amoeba cell lyses, releasing about 100 virion particles. The genomes of these Pandoraviruses have also been sequenced. It was found that 93% of genes of these viruses resemble nothing known. Thus, the name Pandoravirus is a representation of the mysteries to be unfolded here. These viruses are much different than the life we have studied yet. This is also a reminder that much of the life on Earth is yet to be discovered. Scientists believe that Earth is home to 1 trillion microbial species and 99.999% of these species are yet to be identified. Thus, there is a lot we don't know yet and microbiologists still have a lot to explore. These explorations might help us solve various medical and ecological problems and will provide us with new research tools for further understanding the nature of life on Earth. Hi, don't forget to like and share the video and please subscribe to get more videos about the omnipotent microbes.